The AS-90 is the heavyweight of the British Army's arsenal. Its mighty blast shatters the peace and quiet of Northumberland's National Park. These powerful weapons are being controlled further forward, much closer to enemy positions, by a fire support team, which includes experts in mortars, gunnery, and calling in air support. Carefully concealed inside a series of observation posts, they work alongside infantry units, bringing in fire missions to suppress or destroy the enemy. Despite the frontline nature of the role, these days the fire support team commander is just as likely to be a woman.
I strongly believe that any gunner officer that joins, it's the one job that they all want to do, predominantly all want to do. You know, it's seen as the epitome of all gunnery. You know, you're in control of everything happening at the target end. So, you know, why would you not want to do it?
The fire support team is just five or six strong, a close-knit group which on operations is attached to a combat unit, which depends heavily on their expertise.
Last month, the United States military lifted the ban on women serving in close combat roles. And although the UK military is not following suit at the moment, women like Captain Flood are serving in jobs which puts them firmly on the front line.
You're treated as an equal, so you act as an equal. There's no allowances made for you when you're on the front line. The enemy, if you like, they don't see you. They don't look down their scope and see a female. They look down their scope and see an enemy. So it's not something that you consider to be particularly different.
It's a physically demanding role, accompanying infantry units on daily patrols, carrying the same amount of heavy kit and equipment.
I think you'll find a lot of the females that go through Sandhurst relish that challenge and they look forward to that challenge. I see it as something that I aspire to be as good as, if not better, than some of my male counterparts.
It's still very professional in a turret, and she's obviously very competent and it's quite good to work with. It's a nice change.
Exercise Steel Sabre is designed to train these soldiers for contingency operations, the kind of conventional warfare the British Army trained in before Iraq and Afghanistan. Nevertheless, another 2 years of Op Herrick lie ahead.
I suppose going back to the female aspect of it, the only thing I wouldn't want to do is let my team down in any way by showing a weakness, be it physical or emotional weakness.
This is one location where the FST commander's fire missions are actioned. The light guns can be ready to fire in just a matter of minutes. There's a flurry of activity as the battery breaks down the ammunition. Loading the heavy shells is hard physical work, and they will have a devastating impact on the enemy.
It's quite effective, mainly on troops in open. You know, it's not so effective against armour, but certainly we can deliver a good weight of fire on the ground at any one time. And it's more of a suppressive effect on the ground to keep their heads down, to stop them doing what they want to be doing. You know, we can actually stop them in their tracks.
These guns alone have fired 1,300 rounds in the last 12 days. Exercise Steel Sabre is a rare opportunity to put the full remit of what the Royal Artillery does to the test. Charlotte Cross, Forces News, Otterburn.